he must be lifting so much weight at the gym. Me at the gym.
Back at pace. It is now July 8th and I just got a new Pure Boost. Biasanya gua itu yang lemon icy pop flavor. This one, yang ini. Tapi kali ini gua baru aja dapet yang green apple flavor. Moment of truth, green apple flavor. That is delicious. So, I don't have anything. I mean, I don't have any programming today. Kayak udah selesai semua minggu ini, all the back squat, bench press. Pokoknya yang the major lifts udah selesai. Just trying to have fun at the gym today. Gue pengen snatch and see if I still got it. Also, I want to test out how much I can lift. Let's get it. Oke, 60, naik gak ya? Oke, sekarang 70. Lagi nyantai-nyantai kan, giliran pas udah mau berat, datang atlet. Halo Coach Dian, selamat pagi. Atau berasa di judge cuy, tapi tetap kita naikin lagi. 75. Nah, masih naik lah ya walaupun berantakan. Sekarang ini 80. Is it? 25, ya. Yeah. 80. Alright, so hari ini gue mau ngomongin what to do when you're just starting out the gym. Kalau pemula di gym tuh harus ngapain sih? So, untuk itu, gue mau ngobrol sama Coach Edith.
Hello, good morning everyone.
Halo, good morning Coach Edith. So, introduce yourself Coach Edith, nama?
Nama gue Putu Edith, panggil gue Edith or Edith. I have a bachelor's degree in psychology majoring in counseling back in Australia. Terus gue ada certification dari APKI, certified fitness trainer. Dan sekarang gue juga lagi ngambil another certification biomechanics.
Jadi Coach, kalau misalnya orang baru mulai fitness itu di gym, baru mulai nge-gym gitu ya. Apalagi karena ini versi kita, this is a functional gym, functional fitness gym. Apa sih yang di pemula harus lakukan, harus pelajarin gitu?
Okay, so kalian bisa latihan the big three, lifts, yaitu squat, bench, and deadlift.
So this is your warm-up?
This is one of my warm-ups to lengthen the butt muscle. Kelamaan duduk ya guys, jadi yeah. it's not good for you. I usually get some pain while doing this. So I was prescribed to do this, workout.
Oh, jadi buat lengthen, gets the leg ready ya?
Yes.
Oke.
By the way, ini spesifik ya. Not everyone needs this, but I do. It's not that gak semua orang yang baru mulai nge-gym kayak harus punya, always have to have the gear gitu.
Well, if you don't want to invest in a lifter shoe, pakai sepatu apa berarti?
Kalau enggak, ya nggak pakai sepatu dulu juga nggak apa-apa.
Pakai sepatu dulu.
Biasa.
Mendingan nggak pakai sepatu atau
Converse?
Yeah, or Converse. Would you recommend yes. Converse dulu atau nyeker in the beginning?
The beginning probably nyeker.
Nyeker ya.
So find you a gym yang bisa nyeker seperti contohnya Pace.
Okay, so tell me how do you find your rack height?
Rack height kira-kira setinggi collarbone.
Collarbone.
Yeah.
Okay.
Supaya kalau misalnya terlalu tinggi nanti kita harus jinjit buat
mengambil bebannya. Yeah,
and don't... if it's too low, kalau kita terlalu rendah kita udah mulai squat duluan terus capek.
Iya yeah, benar-benar. So you don't wanna jinjit, that's a no-no. Kalau untuk posisi barnya sendiri itu gimana coach? Can you explain?
Posisi barnya itu ada dua. Uh-huh. Ada high bar di atas ini. Uh-huh. Dan ada lagi yang low bar di bawah sini.
Oke.
Okay. Okay, most people will probably just do the high bar squat. It's not necessarily for you to do the low bar.
Mm-hmm. Why? Is low bar more technical?
Low bar is a little bit more technical and it's sport specific too.
Oh yeah, yeah, for powerlifting, yeah. Montage. Other than the bar position, where should your eyes be looking?
Jadi kalau kita melakukan squat, pertama kita mau get under the bar. Jangan kejauhan atau juga jangan deketan sampai kita miring begini. Just stand under the bar. Mm-hmm. Okay. Terus matanya hadap ke depan, sedikit ke bawah. Lalu kita mundur 3 langkah. 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Jangan lupa core tetap engage, upper body tetap engage. Kaki kira-kira selebar bahu, sedikit ngadep keluar. And when you squat, you want your knees to follow the toes. Waktu kita turun, inhale, naik, exhale. Then, ini kenapa juga alasannya, kenapa reket tadi gak terlalu tinggi, biar kita bisa langsung angkat.
Jadi udah masuk bench nih coach ya?
Ketinggian.
Kalau bench sendiri setupnya gimana?
Ketinggian.
Ketinggian ya?
Ketinggian kebetulan ya.
Oke.
Kira-kira sepanjang tangan aja.
Sepanjang tangan, arms length.
Let's see. Should be fine. Kira-kira yang kalau perlu bikin-bikin bisa. Mm-hmm. Okay, kasih lihat. Karena kan nanti kita mau angkat.
Oke. Okay. Jadi rack and racknya nyaman ya? Baru kita posisinya gitu ya?
Kira-kira benchnya ada di bawah dagu. Jadi jangan terlalu jauh ke belakang, jangan juga terlalu jauh ke depan.
Oke. Okay.
Kita di bawah dagu.
Si dagu ya.
Taruh tangannya di bawah garis yang paling luar. Pastiin yang kena di barnya itu adalah lapak tangannya yang paling empuk. Pastiin juga wrist-nya jangan kesalahannya, biasanya suka gini, suka nekuk. Uh-huh. Ini biasanya kesalahannya begini, tapi kita mau wrist-nya lurus. Kalau udah when you're ready, kakinya nampak di lantai. Uh-huh. And then naikin lower ribs-nya, jadi kayak ada there's a little bit of a gap. Mm-hmm. With the bench. When you're ready, then bring it slightly to the front. Inhale turun, naik exhale.
Nice.
Inhale turun, exhale. Belajar conventional deadlift. Jadi pertama kita mau berdiri kira-kira kakinya sejajar dengan bahu ya lebarnya. Habis itu kita juga mau pastiin kalau tempat barbelnya itu kira-kira di tengah-tengah kaki lah. Jadi nggak terlalu nempel dengan shin, nggak terlalu juga jauh. When we're ready, kita akan hinge. Hinge itu artinya kita mundurkan bokongnya ke belakang. Badannya tetap tegak, mungkin ke bawah. Ke bawah, until we reach the bar. Nah, kalau kita udah siap nih, kita mau slide ke bar sampai kayak ada dan kita klik. Mm-hmm. Kita inhale and then exhale. Inhale, exhale. Dan begitulah cara kita melakukan kebiasaan lalu.
So those are the three things you need to master, the squat, bench, and deadlift. Nah, gue tahu pertanyaan selanjutnya nih coach pasti nih. Wah, squat, bench, deadliftnya berapa kali seminggu, berapa sering, apa di hari yang sama, ses repetisinya gimana? Coach tuh pasti ditanyain, gimana jawaban lu?
Ya, tergantung sama program latihannya sih.
Kalau mau bikin sendiri gitu, misalnya pemula buat masterin tekniknya doang, apakah di hari yang sama atau gimana?
Preferably different days. Mm-hmm.
Jadi misalnya Senin squat, besok bench, lusa deadlift.
If you're a beginner, maybe try 3 days a week first. Uh-huh. And then we can increase from there.
No. Terus set repetisinya gimana tuh, coach?
Set repetisinya ya mungkin 10, 12 kali.
Untuk berapa set?
untuk 3 set lah.
3 set oke tuh ya, 10-12 set, that's a good range ya. I agree. Yes. Oke, thank you Coach Edit.
Sama-sama.
Silakan lanjut latihannya.
Okay, so there you have it, my opinion on what I think beginners should try and master at the gym very early on is the bench, squat, and deadlift. This opinion is based on my experience because I've done everything. I've done bodybuilding, CrossFit, calisthenics, you name it. And in my opinion, for longevity, health, and general fitness, you need to master these three big movements, these three big lifts. Different trainer might have different opinion on what you should master early on. Different people, different experience. So should you decide to go down this path of mastering the bench, deadlift, and squat, take it easy. Master the technique, master the form. Watch a bunch of YouTube videos or hire a personal trainer if you want faster results. And when you just started out, just because you can lift big weights, don't rush into adding weights too quickly. Why? Because your muscles will grow faster than your joints can adapt to. Otot itu bakal tumbuh lebih cepat daripada persendian. Jadi jangan sampai nambahin beban terlalu cepat walaupun lu sanggup, karena belum tentu sendi-sendi lu sanggup, belum tentu lutut, bahu, sikut, segala macamnya itu sanggup. So add weight slowly, take it easy. Gunakan program cycling, strength cycling yang progresinya itu nggak terlalu cepat, like maybe 10% increase every month is ideal. With that being said, harus tetap atur nutrisi juga, tidur juga harus cukup, recovery is important, try to get at least 8 hours of sleep every night. I know it's easier said than done, but this thing needs to be done in order for you to grow. Manage stress. I know avoiding stress is impossible, but try to manage your stress as best as you can. Oke, sekian aja video hari ini. Thank you so much everybody for watching. Get out there, get big. Chill Vlog episode 11 is done. Subscribe if this is your jam. Would really appreciate it and help this channel a lot. Leave a like and comments down below. Let me know what you got going on. I'll see you next time. Peace.